savannah is a very important resource for our community and our culture. For 300 years, the Maasai have lived in the savannah, rearing livestock and developing the culture around livestock and the land. It means everything to us. Without it, we have no culture and we have no people.
Amazing morning.
In just a few years, I've seen lots of wildlife disappear, and that makes me feel very bad. Threats to our culture, to our people, and to the Mara ecosystem include expanding wheat cultivation, human-wildlife conflicts, very high human population growth, and high levels of poverty, and the destruction of the ecosystem. Great migration, now recognized as one of the seven wonders of the new world, will be no more. And as a consequence, the Maasai people and the Maasai culture will disappear within a short time. The Maasai will move into the slums, and their culture will disappear, and they'll get into abject poverty in their cities. Nabosho is a Maasai word for coming together, because they felt that running and developing a large conservancy to provide income to community and to protect the wildlife requires extra hands, requires many people to come together to make it happen. The 500 landowners, after they came together, saw that responsible tourism is the best way they can use this land and the best way they can benefit from this land. They looked around and they saw what Basecamp had done in the area around Talek for the last 10 years. And they approached Basecamp and asked Basecamp to be the facilitator of this setting up of this conservancy. In Basecamp, we wanted to demonstrate how responsible tourism can become a platform to manage the land, protect the wildlife, and take care of the people.
Her I Nabosho har vi skapt en win-win-situasjon for alle involverte. Basecamp har skapt en lønnsom bedrift som sikrer lokalbefolkningen jobb og inntekter. Samtidig som vi bevarer det mest unike villmarka du kanskje kan finne i verden. Nabosho-området, dette området som vi ser utover her, kan brukes både til kvegdrift og det kan brukes til jordbruk, men det kan også brukes til ansvarlig turisme. Derfor har 500 Maasai landeiere, de som eier dette området, har kommet til oss og bedt om en samarbeid, og vi har sagt ja. Men det gir oss et kjempeansvar. Altså, vi kan ikke gjøre dette alene. Vi må ha partnere, og det er en del av vårt konsept.
Altså, vi ser at denne formen for turisme som Basecamp her arbeider med, er jo helt i kjernen på den måten Strømmestiftelsen tenker liksom bærekraftig utviklingsarbeid. Så med andre ord, bistand som virkelig viser at det nytter. Med over 30 års erfaring fra bistand, så vet vi i Strømmestiftelsen at samarbeid med lokalbefolkningen og lokale myndigheter, det er nøkkelen til utviklingsarbeid.
Det som er spennende er først og fremst det at det handler om bevaring av dyr i et av verdens mest dyrerige områder. Og Dyreparken har letet etter et sånt prosjekt hvor vi kan se på det med bevaring av dyr samtidig som lokalbefolkningen blir involvert.
Panels to pump the water into this water tank.
Can some of you tell me the importance of planting trees?
They give us shade.
When I meet a lot of my community members, and we talk about Nabosho, I can see and I can hear them saying that their hope is restored by Nabosho. Their hope that there is a future, that there is a future for their livestock, there is a future for the many wildlife that the community, our community has lived with, a future for their children. We cannot do this alone. We need support from people who love wildlife, people who love the savannah, and citizens of the world. We need their support.